and the perfuming, which makes them look like they're a group of rituals connected with the burial of the dead and his existence in the netherworld. There are researchers who see that they are a group of spells describing the ascending of the deceased to the sky or helping him to transform into a spirit in the netherworld. The pyramid texts didn't forget to give an image of the real Egyptian life and what happens inside the palace and the relation between the king and his assistants, although the pyramid texts pictured that to be what expects him in the afterlife. It's noticeable that these texts has offered a strong rhetorical image from the ancient Egyptian against darkness and death, for the texts had never acknowledged death in reality, but it explained it to be an ascending and a transfiguration of the deceased king from the world of humans to the celestial world of the gods in the sky. Like the text which says, King Teti did not die a true death, but he came glorified in the horizon. Or, come on, King Wanis, you have not traveled dead, but you traveled alive. You have traveled so that you can live, and you did not travel to die. You will never die. This King Pepi will not die. The pyramid text expressed the look of the Egyptian to the other life and eternity, although that right was confined to kings and not to the common people, for the Egyptians thought that eternity and immortality lie on the other side of life, which starts after death.